Hi YouTube, it's Kayla, the travel nurse, and today I'd like to give you some first day suggestions. Most of the time when you get your first day instructions, it will be on the Friday before your first day of work. So if your first day is Monday or Tuesday, you will get them on the Friday before. Sometimes this feels like it's a little bit last minute, but this is actually really typical. What I suggest is that when you get your first day instructions, you read those very, very carefully. And should you have any questions at all about where you're supposed to be the first day, or what time you're supposed to be there, or what the expectations are, you need to reach out to your recruiter immediately and get any questions you may have answered. Because the last thing you want is to wait until the weekend and not get a hold of somebody and then show up at the wrong place at the wrong time come Monday morning. So make sure on Friday you are stalking your email and you are waiting for those first day instructions. If you get to your new home a few days early, I suggest you plan out your drive to work and you kind of scope out the area and kind of get like a lay of the land, so to speak, so that come Monday morning you know exactly how long it's going to take you to get there, where you should park, where the entrance is, etc. So I definitely always do that in my practice. I will get to a place a couple days early, I'll get settled into my home, and then the next day before I start work, I will go do a drive-by and kind of plan it all out. That way, you kind of get the jitters out of the way for the first day, you're familiar with the territory, and you know where you're going. And that takes a lot of the stress out of the unknown for the first day. I shouldn't have to say this, but I will, but you definitely need to be at orientation anywhere from 20 to 30 minutes early. That seems a little excessive, yes, but you want to allocate yourself enough time to park, get into the building, get where you need to go. You don't want to be cutting it too close to the last minute. It just is not a good look. That way too, when you arrive and you are early and you're with other travelers, you guys can network and talk to each other. And then you can kind of get to know one another before you even start the day, which is nice. It's nice to know who you're going to be working with. And that extra time gives you that opportunity to do that. If you are a person who values how you look in pictures, your hair and makeup need to be done for the first day. I always look at my ID badges as a souvenir. It's basically like, this is where I've been and I'm proud to have been here. And 10 years from now, when they're in a shadow box on my wall, I want to be able to look at my pictures and be like, oh, I look like I had my act together. I think my very first contract, I didn't expect to get a badge the first day. I don't know why I thought that, but my hair was a mess. I had no makeup on and I was like, oh, I don't want to look like that in every badge photo. So the first day, if presenting yourself all put together is very important to you, then make sure you look your best because you have that badge, you're going to be wearing it, and make sure that your hair and makeup are done the way that you like because you will likely get a badge the very first day. Your first day instructions will specify what to expect for the first day most of the time. Usually it'll say report to this location at 8 a.m. Expect to be there until 5 p.m. That's pretty standard. Usually you're gonna be in a classroom for the first couple days and you can typically anticipate an 8-to-5 type schedule unless your orientation packet says otherwise. I would always anticipate or expect to just be there a full 12-hour shift just in case. You never know. There have been times where I've gotten to contracts, I've done half the first day in the classroom and the rest of the 12 hours on the floor shadowing. So you never know, but make sure you bring your food or anything that you need to survive an entire shift just in case they throw you out there on the floor. You're not blindsided by it. One thing that I'd like to recommend is for you to invest in a folder of some sort that you can keep your certifications in. I have this. I got this at Walmart for a couple of bucks. I keep all of my certifications in this and I keep it in my work bag for the first week of orientation. I do this because even though I have sent all my compliance documents to my compliance officer, sometimes I'll get to a facility and the HR person will ask me for something super random. They're like, oh, I need your PALS card. And that's fine. I have everything like I've talked about before in the CAM scanner app. I have it all saved. However, it's easy for me to just pull this out and just hand them what they need so they can make a copy. And then they hand it back to me and I put it away and that's it. Usually when you can present documents really efficiently, when they ask for them, it'll set a good precedent and they will appreciate your organization. So I definitely recommend you do that. You just get something as simple as this and you just carry it with you the first week. Your choice to carry it with you from there on out, but it's typically not necessary after that point. All right, one important thing I want to talk about is timekeeping. Timekeeping is super duper important. Typically how things work is you will badge in and you will badge out, and the hospital will send a report of your weekly clock ins and outs to your company, and your company will pay you based on that report. What I like to do is I like to use the Timesheet PDF app. This app is amazing at organizing times and putting them into a PDF timesheet. It is so simple to use. A lot of companies will have you do timekeeping and they'll send you a sheet that you can print out and you can document your times in and out on that sheet. But I've used this app. I don't use the sheets that the companies provide me. I just don't feel like printing them out. I don't want to waste paper. I think it's too cumbersome. And I've never had an issue doing that in the past. I like this app because you can put in your times in and out. You can deduct your meal breaks, so it does all the math for you. You can customize your facility with the logo, with the address, your role, whatever information you want to put on that timesheet related to your contract. With the click of one button, it turns it into a PDF and you can share it directly from the app. So I really do appreciate this app and its simplicity. It protects me as a traveler, so that if anything were to happen with the facility and the timing didn't match, or maybe it didn't capture my swipe in or out, then this is a backup for me. And that way it ensures that my hours that I have worked are being clocked carefully. All it does is just a double layer of protection for myself. It makes sure that I get paid on time, I get paid for the hours that I worked, everything matches in both systems, and I'm just good across the board. Now, talking about guaranteed hours, we've talked about this in a past video. Your first week of orientation, typically with most companies, your hours are not gonna be guaranteed. And you will know if it's not because in your contract, it will clearly state whether your hours are guaranteed or not your first week. And usually there is a line that says first week hours not guaranteed, or orientation hours not guaranteed, however the company wants to word it. But just read it very carefully and don't be surprised if you don't get 36 full hours. With your paychecks, you will always be 1 week behind. So your first whole week of orientation, you will not receive that first paycheck until the following Friday. That's why also in another video I recommended that you have enough savings or enough money in your checking account to make it for a few weeks, because you're not going to get paid immediately. So don't be surprised when you start on a Monday and Friday rolls around and you don't get paid. You're not getting paid until the following Friday. So keep that in mind too, because you don't want to bank on, pun intended, money coming in that is going to be a week delayed. And with that being said, at the end of your contract, the following week after the end of your contract, you'll get your last paycheck. So you'll always be a week behind. I know that's pretty standard. I just want to make sure that I reiterate it because I know we've talked about it in the past. That's it, guys. This is a super short video. The bullet points we can take away from are: be on time, be friendly, be professional, be organized, and keep track of your times. That's it. That's all you have to do. These are just things that I have experienced throughout my many years of travel that have been kind of a pattern, and these are things that are pretty standard practice that I wanted to make you aware of, so that it took a lot of the questioning out of the first day, a lot of the anxiety out of the first day. But yeah, you'll do great. You guys will do great. You'll be fine and you'll have fun. If you're looking for a new recruiter, I have some links with reputable recruiters posted down below. And I will see you guys in the next video. Good luck and happy travels.